Hello students, today we discuss about the our chapter is molecular basis of inheritance. In this chapter our next point is experimental confirmation. Then in this experimental confirmation, for that in 1958 Masselson and Stein they perform or semi-conservation replication. How the semi-conservation replication is done, how that from one parental DNA there is a formation of a hybrid DNA, all these things are studied and they are confirmed inside there this experimentation. For that they need certain requirements. What kind of requirements? That is first and most important is E. coli bacteria. From that DNA collected E. coli bacteria, I told you in previous lectures also, that is that from that E. coli bacteria we can collect a DNA sample, okay, or we can collect DNA. Then another is 6M CSCL, that is cesium chloride solution. What is the role of the cesium chloride solution? It has close density to that of DNA. That is a close density to that of DNA. At that time, the ultra centrifugation, when they doing the that work, here this cesium chloride play a very important role. At the time of ultra centrifugation, this 6M CSCL solution density of cesium chloride is matched with the density of DNA. Okay, for that they take this solution, because the density of DNA and density of cesium chloride, they are matched. Next is bacterium culture medium. Bacterium culture medium to grow E. coli bacteria containing 40 NaCl and 50 NaCl. When he want to grow that bacterium, E. coli bacterium, for that they require a supplement of nitrogen, and that nitrogen they get from the this 14N and here I write here this is 14N and 15N, and when this 15N and 14N get from that ammonium chloride, for that he take that ammonium chloride. Okay, then photographic plate, I told you. Then what is the role of photographic plate, and why they take photographic plate? Then spectrophotometer, and last one is centrifuge tube. What is centrifuge tube? Centrifuge tube is just like a tube, and that used inside the centrifugal machine for the formation of centrifugation. Okay. Then let us discuss about the experiment. Matthew and Malson Frankenstein perform experiment to show that DNA replication is semi-conservative. Right? They perform experiment to show that DNA replication is semi-conservative. For that, they grow E. coli in nitrate medium, that is 15N, heavy type of nitrogen. Here, for that, after few generation, he used that 14N DNA. Here, this 14N DNA is grow here in the media, grow on 15NaCl medium for the many generation. Then E. coli bacteria needs or 20 minutes. They take these 14, this E. coli bacteria and grow in on the culture medium. Culture medium is 15 NH4Cl. Okay, for the many generation, they grow now for many generation. And what time required to E. coli bacteria to for completion of one generation? That is only of 20 minutes. Okay, in 20 minutes there is a one generation is completed of whom? Of the E. coli bacteria. Then after that, after a mini generation, he found a 15N DNA inside that. What happened here? In these 15N bacteria, they overcome on that, and they on the culture medium, they take that 15N from that culture medium, they take a 15N, and we found this 15N inside that. Okay. Then this is our G0 stage. We found that in that here that found 15N DNA. Then he provide a 14 NH4Cl solution to grow this E. coli bacteria. He 14 NH4Cl media to grow this E. coli bacteria, and they observe in for the one generation. When in one they take a one generation, here they take a many generation, but inside he take a one generation. In that one generation, what he found? He found there is a presence of 14N. There is a presence of 14N. Then he gave another one generation. After that, what he observed that he get a 15N generation. How can he conclude? How can he surely say that this is 15N, this is 14N? For that, he take that in he take the sample, this sample inside the CSCL solution, and this sample, in this sample, first what he do, he observe, he take the sample of 14N DNA, then the sample of 14N DNA in the CSCL solution he added, and inside the centrifugal tube, and after the centrifugation the light band is formed there. After the centrifugation, there is a formation of light band. The light, because of the light wave, this there here is formation of 14N band, 14N band there. And he take for the observation, he take this centrifuge tube towards the photographic plate. He take here, took here a photographic plate, and what here, what he observed, when he passes the UV rays through that solution, what he observed. And one thing is very important, in spectrophotometer, DNA is absorbed UV rays. DNA, what DNA? The what is the characteristics of DNA? DNA absorb UV ray. That's why there is, when the light passes here, but in this area there is a formation of a band. There is his on photographic plate, there is a dark band is formed there, and he conclude that there is a, this is nothing but that is a 14N DNA is present inside the solution. Okay. Then he take what he do? He take a 15N generation. 15N he grow on 15 NH4Cl medium for many generation, and that he called as a G0 phase. In this G0 phase, he take the sample, and inside the spectrophotometer, on the spectrophotometer, they passes UV rays, and what he observe, there is a formation of band there. Because, and this band is of 15N. Why is 15N present here? Because the density of the 15N is more. That's why they settle down here. They settle down here in the centrifugal tube. And there is a formation of 15N. Okay, then he take a G2, so he take a sample of G1, and that sample he take here, he place on the photographic plate, he passes the spectrophotometer, that is rays of UV rays. From that he found he shocked about that there is a, this is a 14N section, this is a 15N section, but rather than these two, in middle there is formation of one band, and here in photographic plate also there is a formation of one band. Then what is that? Then he observed carefully, and he found that the 14N and this 15N, 14N and 15N, this band, these two DNA are present inside there. That's why this is, he called them as a hybrid. What is called it? This is hybrid. Then his this is about the G1 phase. He again collect the sample, and that sample the centrifuge after the centrifugation. He and after the placing here in, he passes UV rays there on spectrophotometer. What he found? He found a 14N sample, and he found this 15N. And 14N and 15N sample also, this hybrid also present there. This is the overall conclusion. But he graphically he told us like here, like this, the experimentation. Here also we can talk graphically also. Then what is this? What is the, this is the DNA. What is this? Yes, this is the DNA. Yes, and from here we take this DNA from the G0 phase. Where this is 15N, one strand of 15N, one two strands. We told in previous lecture DNA is double helical structure, encoded in nitrogen bases. Phosphorate, they connected with the nitrogen bases, right? And when he done an experiment, he grow in culture media in first generation, what he found in first generation, there is a separation. There is separation of parental template in previous lecture we also study about the what is the template. And this is parental template, this is also parental template. And after that, he found there is one template is formation there, and that is nothing but it is a 14N and 14L. Then he grow for the observation, he done one experiment, he grow for one generation, and he found a four template stand are formed there. Here four template stand, here one stand is there, here one stand is here, here one stand is here, and here we found this one stand is there. The four templates are formed, and with that four templates there is a another stand, there is formed, and that stand is 14N, 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 and 14N. This is the, on the basis of this he conclude that there is a conservation of DNA. From here we found this DNA passes, but they are halfly conserved, and that's why he told that this replication is semi-conservation type of replication. We can I repeat for you. Then they grow E. coli in nitric medium, that is 15N, that is a heavy type of nitrogen. Then after a few generation, all nitrogen bases will contain 15N nitrogen. Okay. Then he transferred to medium containing 14N cell sample, and were analyzed after every replication cycle with technique. Okay. Called as sedimentation equilibrium. That is here centrifugation. Sedimentation equilibrium, that is centrifugation. And in this technique, samples are separated using density gradient. Using density gradient, because of that density gradient, we found this kind of bands there. Centrifugation performed with the heavy metal salt, that like a cesium chloride. This is that salt, that is cesium chloride. And all this experiment, on this the basis of experiment, what Malson has observed that there is a replication, but that replication is semi. That is a semi-conservation. What semi-conservation of what? Semi-conservation of DNA. Here, like this. This template found, we found here, we found here, this template is found here, and that's why we call it as a semi-conservation replication or half conservation of the DNA. This is all about our Malson and Setti's experiment. Thank you.